Sarvo Motors Study Trainer Kit. Order code is 52028. So this is the trainer kit and this is the AC servo motor that comes with the kit. So here this is an inbuilt AC voltmeter. This will show the input voltage. This is the RPM meter. This will show the speed of the motor. This is time constant, and with the help of this knob we can set time. This switch, and this is the DC voltmeter, inbuilt DC voltmeter, range is 0 to 20 volt. This will show the output voltage of the motor. Now here this is the motor speed control section. With the help of this we can vary the speed. This is the motor unit, and here this pin is to connect the motor with the trainer kit. And this is the load part. With this help of this knob we can also vary the load. And this is the user manual, patch box, and the interfacing cable is all included with this kit. Connect the motor with the kit with the help of this cable. So connect this male portion here like this. And connect this part to the motor. Like this. Now our first experiment is determination of a generator constant. For this we are going to build this connection here. So first connect this point here and this point here. Now set the motor speed at 1. Turn on the kit and note down the AC voltage from the AC voltmeter and the speed of the motor, that is the RPM. After that change the speed to 2. Again note the voltage and the RPM. Change the speed to 3. Note the voltage and the RPM. We can see with the help of this motor speed control, we can vary the speed of the motor. Note down the readings here in the table that is given in the manual. Experiment is determination of motor parameters. For this we are going to build this connection here. So now first connect EC with the input. Connect E0 with the positive terminal of DC voltmeter. Connect the negative terminal of E0 with the negative terminal of DC voltmeter. Now also we will connect here the load section to measure the IL. So connect a multimeter. Keep it in DC current mode. Connect the positive terminal to positive terminal of the multimeter and connect the negative terminal to the negative common terminal of the multimeter. Keep this knob at no load position. Now turn on the kit and note down the reading. This is EC and here this is the voltage E0 and IL current will be measured in the DC with the help of this multimeter. After that, and IL will be measured in this multimeter. So note down this reading that is in the table that is given here. So for the first step, we will take the readings when there is no load. After that, we will change this to load 1 and note down the EC. This is EC value, this is the RPM, this is E0 and this is IL. And the second step is change this position to load 2 and again note down this value in this table given here. Also, with the help of this formula, we can determine the different parameters of the motor. Next experiment is determination of transient response. So this is the circuit diagram that we are going to build. So here the circuit connection is exactly same like the previous connection. So first turn on the key. So this is the input voltage, this is the RPM and this is the DC voltmeter showing the output voltage. Now from this positive terminal, connect this positive terminal ES and connect this. After that, turn off the key and wait for 30 seconds. Now, after 30 seconds, again turn on the kit and we can see here it is showing the transient response time of the motor in millisecond. Again, remove these patch cords, select this load at 1, turn on the kit, observe the input voltage RPM and the output voltage. Now again connect the positive terminal of this voltmeter to the positive terminal of ES and the negative terminal to the negative terminal of ES and turn off the key and wait for 30 seconds. After 30 seconds, turn on the key and observe the transient response time of the motor, which will be shown in millisecond at load 1 position. Like this, repeat again, change the position at load 2 and repeat this above steps.